Hey, hello, everybody. I'm Awais, and I'm going to talk a little bit about template literals. Template literals are new type of strings in JavaScript that actually use backticks. Fun things about these template literals are that they can be used to create multi-line strings, or they can have an embedded JavaScript expression inside of them. This could be a variable. There's also a third feature they offer that if you define a function here, it becomes a tag template, which has access to all of the string parts and the expression inside the string. Template literals are enclosed by backtick characters. Backtick characters look like these. Instead of, you know, using double or single quotes that you see in a normal JavaScript string, template literals can contain placeholders with dollar signs and curly braces that look like these, and they could be JavaScript expressions. Let's see how all of this works. I'm going to define a string. Let's call it str. And I'm going to define a name. My name is going to be, let's imagine that this is a variable. It sends a request to an API and gets back this particular name. So it has to be a variable that is called name. And my name is Awais, right? So a normal JavaScript string would look like this. We'll have double or single quotes. And I will say my name is, and I will add a space plus name. And then I'm going to just quickly go here and console log the string. All of this makes sense. It actually concatenates this particular string with this particular variable and creates this particular string. My name is Awais. If I had to do this with template literals, I will just type something like this. String is equal to backticks. My name is name. This particular thing is a JavaScript expression here. This expression signifies this particular variable, and we are using dollar sign and curly braces inside of the backticks, and the output is pretty much the same, right? What if I wanted to add more information to the string? Let's say I define a course, and that course is nodecli.com, where I'm teaching how to create Node CLI automation, right? And I want to add that here. I will have to add another plus sign, single quotes, and then I will write check out my new course plus course. And I think there is an error here, so I'll probably have to add a space here. And now it becomes my name is Awais, check out my new course nodecli.com, right? And this isn't looking really good right now. You know, a bunch of strings and variables concatenated together to create this output that I actually right now had to debug. I didn't know I had to, you know, add a space here or whatnot. If I were to do the same thing with template literals, it would look really good. For example, my name is Awais, check out my new course, right? This looks really simple as compared to the old string, a string that has different JavaScript variable values inside of it, you know? So we use these JavaScript expressions right inside these backticks, and it all just makes sense. You know, these are placeholders for variables. I could have a name, let's say, my wife's name, Maida, and a course on VS Code.pro. And you will see that these variables would just work. What if I wanted to add a new line here? For the older strings, if I enter here, you will see it just breaks, right? There are a bunch of errors right now in here. So I might have to add something like a slash n to signify that this is going to be a line break. And if I hover over it, you will see that there are now two lines. This is looking really, really weird. Let's see how we can do this in template literal. For that, I'm just going to go ahead and press enter. And if you take a look at this actual string output, you'll see my name is Awais, check out my latest course. And it just works. If I add a new line before this, you'll see it still just works, right? So when using templated strings, we use backticks. It allows us to use multi-lines and embedded expressions right here. I believe template strings or template literals are a better way to write strings than the old single quotes or double quotes way of, you know, concatenating and creating a dynamic string. So that is pretty much about it. I love template strings. I recommend that you start using them right away.